Hi everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Maria, and today we're taking a look at the Love Every, the Helper Play Kit, for ages 25 to 27 months. As always, we're going to take a look at what is actually in the play kit, whether this is something that makes sense for your personal family to purchase, what alternatives we can find online to give us more value for our money or provide us savings, and as always at the end, we're going to take a look at what ways we can recreate these activities with what we have at home to provide an even more significant savings. Now, as always, I do have to mention, Love Every does make high quality items that are Montessori friendly, and they're not necessarily a bad investment. These are simply alternatives if the actual play kit isn't in your budget, and it doesn't seem like your little one would be interested in everything that is in the play kit. And with this play kit in particular, you may find that you have most everything that you already need for your little one. So let's take a look at what is actually in the helper play kit. The first is the super sustainable sink with bio-based cups and plates. This is a sink that allows your child to have continuous water play, as the water does recycle itself, so you're not wasting water while the child can engage in some water sensory and pretend play. The drop and match dot catcher is essentially a take on Connect 4, but it has four different colors, so your little one can practice their fine motor skills while also continuing to practice color matching. The felt flowers in a row is a take on the Montessori flower arranging activity. The felt flowers have a quite thick stem, and it comes with this board that you're able to actually post the flowers into. The premise here is that you're also able to work on counting with these flowers as well. Double-sided sunny day puzzle presents a welcome challenge for the child that has mastered all of the puzzles that they have available to them at this point. The child has to manipulate the different geometric shapes together to create the two pictures that are available to them. Anywhere art kit with washable tempered paint sticks is just that. It's a little to-go art kit that has several pieces of paper, as well as five different colored washable tempera paint sticks. The interesting thing with tempera paint sticks is that they glide very smoothly like paint, but just like crayons, they are dry to the touch and they don't smear and get everywhere. Because they are washable, even if they are to get all over the place, you can easily wash them off. The Let's Map It Out routine cards present a visual way for the child to know what transitions are coming up next, and maybe a wonderful way for our toddlers to know what to expect and get ready for those difficult transitions. The Making Muffins board book takes us to the process of making muffins while also exploring the concept of counting. Now, with this play kit in particular, I challenge you to not look at whether these items look fun and interesting to you, but what it is that your child personally is currently interested in, and how many of these items lean into what it is that your child is interested in. Because yes, the Love Every play kits are always very aesthetically beautiful and pleasing and inviting to look at. But if I am to think about what it is that my toddler, who is 26 months going on 27 months, is currently interested in, actually very few of these items. What she personally is very interested in right now, which I think is going to align with a lot of your little ones as well, is gross motor skill development, coloring, pretend play, and building things. There are three areas of study that she's very, very concentrated on figuring out right now, which is animals, the solar system, and the globe, none of which are really found here. Aside from the washable tempera paint sticks, yes, she would definitely give some attention to these items, but these would not be enough to hold her attention for the 3 months that this play kit is designed for. I would still need to supplement her with the activities that actually provide something that is of interest to her personally. This play kit in particular, it really feels like a filler play kit. Something that our kids might show some interest and some attention towards, but is not actually feeding into what they're craving and very interested in exploring right now. For example, the play sink. This is something that would have been wonderful before our little ones even turned a year old. That is one, the concept of water running was so fascinating to them that we had the issue of the water continuously running, and something that allowed them to just explore water freely without wasting it would have been perfect. However, at this point, we have moved well into utilizing an actual sink and using that sink to set up other water type activities like sink and float or pouring or transferring with water. And so while this is something that our little ones might be interested in, there's certainly more advanced items that they're going to be even more interested in. The drop and match dot catcher is very similar to the item that we just looked at in the previous play kit. But now instead of having to push the different colored items to make a pattern, we're simply dropping them in on the top. But this motion of dropping a disc into a slot and making sure that it's rotated the correct way is something that we worked on with the Imbikari boxes in much earlier play kits. That is an item that I recommended DIYing, and if your little one is interested in a variation of this, you could very easily kick it up a notch and simply create multiples of these with the different colors, and then you'll have your own version of this as well. But you may notice that at this age right now, your child doesn't need a lot of stuff. They just need the space and the ability to try things on their own. They're very interested in trying things by themselves and simply becoming more proficient and better at doing things independently that they have been working on up until now. So for the sake of comparison, let's go ahead and take a look at every single item and what we can find as alternatives online, how that compares to the cost, but at the end we will talk about all the items that we can simply recreate with what we've got at home and how much more of a significant savings we will have. With this kit, we will have the two running totals, one which will be the total that you will spend for all of the items that we're looking at for alternatives, but on this side will be the per item total. And if you remember, this is for the items that we're purchasing more of versus the plate kit. So for example, that sunny side puzzle, you'll notice that we have just that one block with the two pictures, but our alternative will have five of those blocks. So it's not really fair to compare the five different options versus the one. So here you will have the price for those total five, but on this side, we will be comparing what one of those blocks will cost. That way we have a fair one-to-one comparison of what the play kit will cost based on the number of items that Love Every is providing you. Taking a look first at that play sink, there's not a shortage of other play sinks out there that do the exact same thing. They recycle the water, so your little one is able to use it for pretend play. In general, they're going to run you between $20 to $30. For the sake of comparison, I'm going to include this one from Little Tykes in our price comparison because this is a brand that I do know and trust, but I will provide some additional options for you over in my Amazon storefront if this isn't the exact one that you think would work for your family. But I think it goes without saying that this is not something that you absolutely need. You can allow your little one to explore water without wasting it by simply filling up a bowl or bucket of water. You have a water table outside, they can utilize that. And while our little ones are interested in exploring pretend play options, they're just as, if not more, interested in exploring what the family's actually doing. Real water for real life scenarios like washing their hands, food prep, or washing dishes. If you have a kitchen helper or your little one is stable enough to stand on a chair, they can stand at the actual sink with you. If you have a pleat kitchen, you can easily convert most of them to be functional kitchens and allow your child to use it for both pretend play and actual water work. Also allow your child to explore water through simple pour and transferring activities. But for the sake of comparison, we will go ahead and include this Little Tykes play sink in our running total. For this drop in my stack catcher, I think when we see this item, the first thing we all think of is Connect 4, which is certainly an option that we can explore. While this is a little bit different, I'm actually going to include these Math Link cubes in our comparison total. Here we're still working that fine motor skill by putting the cubes together. We're actually working a lot more hand strength to make sure that they actually lock. They have pattern cards, so you can actually work more on making different patterns. We're also making more 3D shapes, which is more of a geometric understanding than what we have with the Love Every comparison, but this item will also grow with your child. As they get more and more interested in the concept of math and numbers and counting, you can use it for simple cards and counters. We can use it to see the difference between the length of one cube versus 10 cubes. We can also see the difference between one singular stick of 10 cubes and 10 singular cubes, which is the beginnings of a classic Montessori bank game, which is done in the 3 to 6 age class. Now, if these cubes aren't your speed, the other main premise of this Connect 4 type game is turn taking. You can take a turn and then your child can take a turn and you can start to understand that basic turn taking concept that is needed for board games. Another way that we can explore that is through an actual first board game. This is one that we got for Stella for her birthday and she has been absolutely in love with it. It still works on color matching. We're still working on some fine motor skills, but we're also very much working on an actual game with some rules and some turn taking. I will go ahead and include these Math Link cubes as our comparable item for the play kit. For the felt flowers in a row, we can go ahead and recreate this with other felt flowers that are sold online. Like I mentioned, this will be the total for all of the felt flowers that are sold in this pack. And this will be the comparable for the five flowers because in Love Every, we are getting only five of the flowers. So to be fair with the comparison, this is the total for the five flowers. Now Love Every does have them in that one stand, so you can stand all five flowers together. We have not had a shortage of posting practice at this point with our children, and having all the five flowers lined up in one line in five is not necessarily going to provide them all that much practice in counting anything other than five. Because with the one-to-one correspondence, if we're counting one flower, we would actually want the slot just to be for one flower. And if we're counting two, we would want the slot to be for two. This is where those math cubes really would come into play, and you can utilize those to work on that one-to-one correspondence and that counting. Instead, we can take those felt flowers and we can turn to any local craft store or thrift store to buy some small vases for a fraction of the cost if you don't already have any kind of vases or other containers that you can utilize for some simple flower arranging. If you go in person, you'll often have a lot more options. Even the Target dollar spot often has a very nice selection of quite reasonably priced small vases for you to utilize. Another alternative to this would be to buy the fake flowers that are sold at the craft store. A lot of times just the one single stem of flowers at the top has multiple flowers. Some of them you have to cut off, some of them you can actually pull off, and now you'll have your five flowers to work with. If you want, you can still go ahead and utilize the little vases for that, Or if you want to make it more comparable to the Love Every, you can simply take a box and pre-make a couple of holes and have your child practice posting the flowers into those holes. Best alternative to this would be to do actual flower arranging. And you don't need to buy anything new. You can go outside and pick some dandelions or some other wildflowers that are growing outside. You can utilize whatever containers you have around the house. You can do a simple flower arranging, but it will provide your child with a lot more sensory exploration and the need to be a lot more refined in their movement and a lot more intentional in making sure that they get the water into the actual container. Be very careful with the flowers, not to hurt them. And if your child has started to show an interest in scissor skills, they can even cut those flowers to be to size. You can also purchase some very simple bouquet filler flowers and use vases that you already have, or again, cups, mugs, glasses. But to be fair, for the sake of comparison, I'm going to go ahead with the most comparable option and the one that's going to cost us the most, which are these felt flowers and these vases. Now for the puzzle. This is a very interesting puzzle, but one that lacks scaffolding. Before your child is actually able to manipulate the different independent geometric shapes, for example, taking two triangles and making them into a square, they will first need to scaffold into that skill of understanding that different shapes can be used to represent and symbolize different pictures. That is what this Melissa and Doug alternative does. Every shape has one singular slot that they can fit into and allow your child to really see that these geometric shapes have a representation and they symbolize something. Eventually we can move into the Tanagram style puzzles where the child actually still has a guide and a picture that shows them exactly where to place each geometric shape in order to create the picture that they're making. And then the child will have scaffolded to the point where they understand that they can take different geometric shapes to create a larger, different shape. So yes, a child will be able to understand and figure out Love Every's singular puzzle, but that does not mean that they have understood the concept of how these shapes work together. They have simply learned how to solve this one particular puzzle. If you want your child to actually work on that understanding of the geometric shapes and how they fit together and how they can work together to make symbols, how they can work together to make other geometric shapes, I would recommend starting with something like this Melissa and Doug puzzle, and that's what we're going to include for the comparison. And like I mentioned in the beginning, the Melissa and Doug option does have 5 double-sided pictures for you to work with. So again, this is the total for all 5 of those, but on this total, we're only going to include what one of those essentially costs. Next is their travel art kit with the washable tempera paint sticks. I'm actually going to include this one in our comparison, which is washable, it's non-toxic, and it is still tempera paint sticks. But again, we do have 12 versus the 5. And for an item like this that is going to eventually run out, definitely makes more sense to invest in something that you have more of. You'll notice in the art kit, they also do have several pieces of paper that go along with the tempera paint sticks. So we'll go ahead and include this sketchbook, which is definitely going to have way more pages than the one that Love Every offers. Because I don't know how many exactly they offer, we'll just go ahead and include it as the cost of one. Personally, this is not the type of item that I would take on the go, because while it is washable, if it gets over something like a car seat or a stroller or a nice outfit if we're out to dinner, that's definitely still going to be a bit more of a headache versus something like this option where you only draw on the actual paper that is designed to be used with these markers. So if you're looking for an actual on-the-go option that's not going to get everything around you dirty, this is the style that I prefer to travel with. The routine cards is something that a lot of families find incredibly useful, especially for the child that has a hard time transitioning from one activity to the next. Personally, in our family, we haven't had the need for this, so I actually went to see what other people had to say about the routine cards that Love Every included. And the biggest complaint that I saw is that there is not any particular way for these cards to be displayed. Because they are thicker, you can't simply use a magnet to stick them to your fridge. You would have to actually put the magnets on the back yourself, or you would need to create some kind of system where you use maybe pins to pin them on a string somewhere. In that case, some kind of alternative that is already a magnet may be preferable. Unfortunately, all of these are much more cartoonish, so while they are lifelike and they are realistic, they're not necessarily as beautiful as the actual photographs that Love Every uses. A more similar comparison is this option at Etsy that does utilize actual photographs of actual children performing these tasks. However, it is a download file only, so you would still need to print them out, and if need be, you would need to laminate them. However, because these are much more similar to what Love Every offers and both still end up needing some work, I will go ahead and include this one in our comparison, but I will leave links for the ones that are on Amazon that already come as magnets. Personally, I would recommend just going the full DIY option here and just taking a picture of your child as they go through whatever routine it is that you're working on. That way you have something that is very customized and very easy for your child to connect between what it is that they're currently doing and what is expected of them, what room they're going in, and what task it is that they're going to be doing. And finally is the Making Muffins book that also works on counting. And there is a similar book on Amazon that also works on counting through the process of baking. So taking a look at all of the comparable options that we discussed, we're looking at a total cost of just under $113, remembering that some of these items are going to grow with your child for a lot longer than the Love Every option. But if we're to compare apples to apples and take a look at the same number of items with our play kit versus what Love Every is offering, we're looking at a cost of right around $87, which is definitely a significant savings over the $120. However, let's also go ahead and take out the cost of the items that we can recreate at home with what we already have. For example, the play sink, we can certainly just replace with our own sink or simply a bowl of water. The felt flowers, we can simply do flower arranging, even if it's just with dandelions outside and a glass of water. And the routine cards, we can simply create by taking pictures of our own child. That way, we bring the cost of the play kit to under $60, which makes it less than half of what the Love Every play kit costs you. And instead, if you do have the budget left over, you can actually utilize that money to purchase something that is going to cater specifically to your child's unique interests and needs. I really encourage you to take a look at this play kit with a very critical eye, really considering what it is that your unique child is interested in exploring right now. And I hope these comparisons and ideas have allowed you to do just that. And until next time, I hope you stay safe.